So good morning, dear student. I think during last lecture we have seen the importance of different tables. In tabular form, we tried to explain if there is a dependent, independent variable, one dependent, one independent, whether they are metric or non-metric. So one table we have finished. Okay, the second table we will be going to learn, and then today we are going to use those concepts for testing the hypothesis. I think we were there in this table only. Am I right? Just finish this table, then last table we will do it, and then directly today we are going to use these things for our practical practice through MS Excel. So it indicates if there is bivariate. Bivariate means there are two variables. Okay, one is dependent variable, another is independent variable. If both are metric, then we will apply the simple regression. Okay, say for example, relationship between sales and advertisement expenditure. We know as much as we do the advertisement, that much sales will enhance. And that is proven. I have done it. Yes. We have seen the expenditure which is enhancing the sales. So as much as we will do the expenditure, that much the sales will increase. And with this, we can also predict if we will make this is expenditure, what could be the sales. So that is known as regression. Okay. So through correlation regression and, simple regression also we can understand their applicability, and accordingly we can follow, we can apply. Second, if it is non-metric, if your dependent variable is non-metric and independent variable is metric, then you have to go for logistic regression. Logistic regression you will have to apply. Now, what I have done here to study a study to the relationship of advertisement expenditure on different area or different product. If suppose product A, B, C, that cannot be computed or can get in metric form. That will always be in non-metric form. Whereas expenditure will always be in metric form. I hope you have understood why I have taken this to get one metric and another non-metric data. Third, if my dependent variable is metric and independent variable is non-metric, to study the impact of sales, there is a spelling error over here, on gender. Okay, so sales is metric data and gender is non-metric data. Okay, and if there is a cross-tabulation in the sense, if both are non-metric, sales is also not given in the amount. Sales is given as high, low, and moderate. And gender is already, male and female. In such cases, you cannot apply any kind of regression or any technique. In such cases, you will have to apply only cross-tabulation. So cross-tabulation, before this, I have explained here also for chi-squared test. Cross-tabulation is required. This is cross-tabulation where the data is in ABC form. And finally, you can get the pivot table and that will give you cross-tab. Which student belongs from which division? Even at the very beginning, I have explained this cross-tabulation here. How many UG, PG? This is called cross-tabulation. So non-metric data also, we can get in number form, that is known as cross-tabulation. So it says that 8 female, which are PG qualified out of 17. It says 9 male, which is PG qualified out of 17. This is called cross-tabulation. Okay. The same cross-tabulation we have applied here also, chi-squared test. okay, based on cross tabulation, which is there in this table. I hope this table is clear to you all. If you have completed, please let me know, then we will proceed further. Very important table. Completed, everyone? Have you completed? Thank you. Then go for last table, which is for multivariate analysis. If one dependent variable is metric and both are metric, you have seen just now multiple regression, non-metric and metric linear discrimination analysis. Okay. If more than one variable, structure equation, model path analysis, Mankova, ANCOVA, ANOVA. Likewise, if there is multivariate, if there are many variables, then we apply ANOVA. And here I have applied ANOVA. When there is single factor ANOVA, two factor ANOVA, so on and so forth. So take this table, then we will apply these things in Excel. Now I hope once I will teach you Excel, you will be understanding why I'm teaching all those concepts. So take down fast. And if there is mix, more than one variable, then log as same as above they have discussed. Take down fast. Dear student, now all the assignments and Viva, I think as per the schedule given to you, I will be taking on that day. I don't know when it is. Okay, your class teacher, we have already signed those notices. I think your class teacher must have given you in your group. Please check your assignment and Viva day. Subject wise assignment and Viva has been assigned. Let me give you certain guidelines. Just now, today I have just shared one student project report. Likewise, we have more than 270 project reports. Okay, few best of them I am uploading on my website also, or internship report, which will help you for future. See how effectively he has done it from last year. He has presented many papers. He has published many papers. And all the details he has mentioned at end. So likewise, from now only, Vivas, Rushik, and other students who are under my guidance, they started their research last year, and this year they were in very comfort zone. Why? Because in 1 year they have done many things, and that is the basic idea of putting this research methodology in semester 4. Completed. If it is done, please update. Then we'll go for next. Thank you. One more, if it is mixed variable, more than one is mixed. NVA and OVA, same as above. So here with your all tables are over. I'm not getting Ria. What about C1? What exactly it is? You can unmute and you can tell us. Let me see with, I'll talk to the exam committee and then I'll get back to you on this. So I hope you must, I hope you must have completed this. And as you know, just now I told you, these are few things. If there is a metric data, we need to apply parametric test. This table, you should keep it. This table is there with you for testing your hypothesis. If not, please take it. Then today I'm going to teach you what is t-test, pair t-test, everything we are going to learn. Yeah, I will check those books. Devang, again, you are asking the same question. Let me first teach the student how they are going to apply these things for analyzing their data. And I'm very happy. There are few students who have sent me their questionnaire also to fill it up. Very good. One student is doing during pandemic, how the teaching is going on, online teaching is up to the mark or not. So accordingly, they must have started collecting the data. And now, once they will collect the data, next part also I need to teach them. that is why let me finish. It will require one or two lectures, then we will have other discussion. Portion is almost, over long back. It is just we are learning the practical applicability of it. Kaveri, you cannot keep such kind of open topic as dowry system case in court. You have to be very specific what exactly you wanted to do. If you will let me know, then I can give you the proper title. And I told you, title should be very comprehensive. Like how the movie title is giving entire detail of movie. Isi tarah, aapka title bahut hi perfection hona chahiye. Title mein agar error hua, so phir nobody is going to read your research. Exactly करना क्या है आपको? अनम्यूट करो और मुझे बताओ, then we will discuss. What related to dowry? What kind of study you want? Yeah, we all understand about dowry whereby girls family paid for their marriage. But aapka objective kya, aap karna kya chahte ho? Unmute karo na, bolo na. There is option available to you. No, it's working. Abhi just Riya ne answer diya mujhe. Riya, you can unmute.
Yes, sir.
It's working. Okay. So until unless we'll get to know what exactly you wanted to do, it will be difficult for us to help you. Because title is very important. Completed. So you must have seen in metric data, if there is only one sample, we will go for t-test. If there are two sample, there also we can go for t-test. If there are paired sample before and after, then paired t-test. And if there is non-parametric, one sample chi-square, okay? If two sample chi-square, Benz-Whitney test. Pair sample, there also chi-square and Wilkinson test also is there for non-parametric data. Everyone completed? And again, I'm telling you, those who are having the laptop, they will understand in better way. मोबाइल में ये सारे प्रोविजंस आने डिफिकल्ट है. तो यहां तक आपका थियरी कंप्लीट हो गया सब कुछ. नाउ लेट अस अप्लाई देम इनटू प्रैक्टिकल. सो आपने देखा था डिस्क्रिप्टिव में हाउ आई हैव टेकन दिस एज अ टाइटल, अ स्टडी ऑफ ओवर स्पीडिंग ऑफ कार ड्यूरिंग नाइट एंड ऑल. दिस इज ऑल फॉर डिस्क्रिप्टिव एनालिसिस. एंड कोई भी डेटा रहेगा, फर्स्ट दे आर गोइंग टू गिव यू द डिस्क्रिप्टिव एनालिसिस ओनली. कोई भी टाइप का टेस्ट करेंगे ना, first they are going to talk about mean, median, mode, standard deviation, quartices, range, maximum, minimum, count, कोई भी type का research कर, कोई भी output पहला यही सब चीज देगा. Then now let us understand how the t value for table and t value what you are getting it. Okay. So now This is the question. The height of 10 male is given in a locality. Itna inches hai unki height. It is reasonable to believe that average height is greater than 64 inch. Greater than, matlab less than ki chances hi nahi hai. Less than ki chances nahi hai, matlab hum log 1 tel ka p value dekhenge. Very clear. यानी मुझे क्या ढूंढना है, मेरा हाइपोथेसिस क्या बोलने की कोशिश कर रहा है? The data which are more than 64 inches, not below 64. Okay. One tail and two tail, you will understand. Okay. A random sample of 10 boys whose IQ score is this. Okay. Do the data assumption population mean is 100 at 5% level of significant. So, hamara kisi ko 70 aya, kisi ko 120 aya, kisi ko 110 aya. Bolta hai 100 se niche aur 100 se upar. Dono mujhe mil sakta hai. Okay, so in that case, I am going to take the two tail. But here, I need to take only one tail. Why? Because less than 64 inches, there is no scope. There is no choice. Okay, if you are testing your hypothesis at 5% level of significant, what do you mean by level of significant? Now, let us understand this. Level of significance is very, very important. Why it is important? Because it has lot of values. Say, for example, two students came to me during lockdown. They are giving online exam and their result is very good. You know, many of them, they are getting 95%. So, one student got exact 95%. Other student got 94.99%. They both came to me and they stated, sir, mujhe 95% marks I have. I clapped them. Okay. Very good. But one student, because of one less mark, is lower than 95. Now I have declared the topper will get 10,000 rupees. So here, that other student who got 94.99999 will not go into and will not be eligible for the prize. Why? Because 0.00000001% is going to have lot of impact. I hope you must be understanding now level of significant, how important word when we frame the hypothesis. Okay. So randomly I have selected, I told you how to get the random. There should not be any bias. You take the chit and collect these data. So, randomly, I have selected the height of a student, and finally, we need to check. Okay, there is only one sample. There is no another sample through which we can test it. Okay, two sample mein hoga, two alag alag divisions se le sakte hain. Here, it is only one sample. Okay, when there are two sample, then there are two database. So one sample t-test अपने को apply करना है. Average बोल रहा है मेरे को 60 सबका 64 से above आना चाहिए. तो अभी मेरे पास data आया. Let me see whether it is perfect or not. Okay. So one sample, assuming unequal variance. Okay. This is given. And now I have frame the hypothesis also. There is no significant difference between assumed mean. Assumed mean matlab 64 inches and mean of random sample. Mean of random sample is how much? 66. There is no significant difference. Let me see whether there is a significant difference or not. That we will get to know with the p-value. If the p-value is less than 0.05, okay, then we will reject the null hypothesis and we will accept the alternative hypothesis. Rejecting the null hypothesis means there is no significant difference between assumed mean or hypothetical mean and mean of random sample. There is no much difference between 64 and 66, but if it is got rejected, means that is there is a significant difference. So again, in subsequent lecture, I'll teach you how to apply this. Just try to understand today. So again, I told you, we have got mean, we got variances, we got observation, we have seen the hypothesized mean difference, we have got the degree of freedom, we have got the p-value of statistics, we got the p-value of 1-10. So here 1-10 p-value I will take. And what are the presumption? If p-value is less than 0.05, then we are going to reject, okay, the null hypothesis. If it is more than 0.05, then we will write fail to reject. We cannot say accept. We will write fail to reject the null hypothesis. So if you are rejecting the null hypothesis, that means you are assuming the and accepting the alternative hypothesis.